G'day everyone, it's Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. In this week's video, I'm going to talk to you about factors and multiples of 3 and 9. This comes from this ebook, 10 Minutes a Day Level 3, book number 4, Factors and Multiples. So we're going to be looking at teaching our students how to determine whether a number has 3 or 9 as a factor, or the other way around of saying that is it a multiple of 3 or 9? Now, with any divisibility test, one way is simply to divide and see what happens and, you know, go through the steps and see if you get the answer. But clearly we're looking for something a bit faster than that. And so here's a collection of numbers and we want to test which of these are divisible by 3. Now, the method that we can use, which is really neat, I remember being quite excited when I heard about this, is that if you add the individual digits together, if the sum of the digits is a multiple of 3, then the entire number is a multiple of 3, which I think you'll agree is pretty neat. So we can start with a number like 24 and see clearly that it is a multiple of 3 because 2 plus 4 equals 6. Now, of course, we also know that 24 is 3 times 8. So if we recognize any of these just from knowing number facts, that's going to be even faster and you don't have to add it up. Another method, of course, is to look for a number like 93. That's a multiple of 3 also because each of the digits is a multiple of 3. So the students by this age will hopefully know the division algorithm. They'll know what happens when you divide by a single digit, and so they should be able to see that one straight away. Let's look at the others. 4 plus 6 is 10, so that's not a multiple of 3. 6 and 2 is 8, neither is that. 5 and 1 is 6, so that's good. That is a multiple of 3. If you know that one, you don't even have to check 52 because that's 51 plus 1 more, so that can't be a multiple. 7 plus 8 is 15, 8 plus 4 is 12. There's two more multiples. So it's relatively easy to do. I think it's one that the students will enjoy because it's so easy and, you know, you can have fun with it. Now, we're only doing two-digit numbers here, but it works for any size number. So, you know, you can easily extend this to other questions for students. Let's look at some other numbers. So we're looking for multiples of 9 this time. Let's see what we've got. Now, all of these are fairly easy if we only use two-digit numbers. So let's add some harder ones. So we'll have okay. And we might throw in that one. Okay. Now, the method for multiples of 9 is almost exactly the same. If you add the digits together, if the sum of the digits is 9 or a multiple of 9, then the number is divisible by 9. Now, the students probably already know that, having learned the 9 times table well before the tables before they get to here. They know that the sum of the pairs of digits is always 9, and so some of these are going to be really easy. That one, and that one straight away, and this one. The sum of the digits is 9. So as I said, the two-digit ones are pretty easy. Three digits, we've got to actually think about it. 108, if they know up to 12 times 9, that's it. We've got that one. 1 plus 0 plus 8 is 9. 1 plus 6 plus 1 is only 8. That can't be a multiple of 9. 4 plus 3 is 5 plus 2. That's only 7. 2 plus 5 plus 2 is 9, so that is a multiple of 9. So the approach, as I said, is fairly straightforward. Students should be able to do this one quite easily. And we're finished. So I'll talk to you next time.